Yeah, this is Yosefu, Assistant Professor of CS Department, St. Martin's Engineering College. So I would like to give presentation on arrays concept. It is very easy to understand. Let me give a simple example to understand about the arrays. Now let us take a variable. Okay, a variable is a data name which holds a data value. That is a basic definition of a variable, or it is a name given to the memory location where the data value is stored. So different definitions are there for the variables. Let us take int a is equal to 10. So here int is a data type and a is variable name and this is assignment operator and value is 10, that is integer value. So we have stored a value in this variable. So for example, if you execute this program, so system will allocate memory space for this variable. No, system will allocate, operating system will allocate memory space for this variable A. Okay, how much space? That is depends on the size of the data type. Okay, what is the data type here? Integer. So the size of the integer depends on the mission. Okay, let us assume that the size of the integer is 2 bytes. So system will allocate 2 bytes of space for this variable A. Now this is a memory. Okay, now this is a memory. System allocated some amount of memory for this variable A. Okay, now this value 10 will be stored in this space. Now what do you understand? What is the definition of the variable? The name given to the memory location. Now this is a memory location. This is a memory location. What is the name of this memory location? A. What is the value of this memory location? 10. And system will assign address also. For example, 65,520. Okay. Right. Now there is a basic definition of the variable. So what is a variable? A name given to the memory location where the data value is stored. Okay. Now I want to store one more value also, that is 20. For example, A equal to 20. A equal to 20. So I have assigned another value to variable A. Now what will happen? So already A variable A consisting of value 10. Again, we are trying to store another value, that is 20. Now, what will happen? This value will be erased or replaced by new value, that is 20. Okay. So, old value, that means previous value, will be replaced by new value. Now, what do you understand? A single variable contains only single value at a time. A single variable contains only single value at time. Now, for example, if you want to store two values, we have to use two variables. Okay. For example, if you want to store a single variable, or if you want to store single value, we have to use one variable. If you want to store two values, we can use two variables. Okay. So, if you want to store three values, we can use three variables. Okay. So if you want to store 100 values, we can use 100 variables. So if you want to store 1000 values, we have to use 1000 variables. Now it is not an efficient method. It is not a good method using more number of variables and storing different values. Okay. So what is the disadvantage here? What is the problem with this? What is the limitation? A single variable contains only single value at a time. So to overcome this problem, so if you want to store two values, we are using two variables. If you want to store three values, we are using three variables. Okay. So if you want to store 10 values, we are using 10 variables. Okay. So it is not an efficient method. So C language provides a new technique or alternate method, that is arrays concept. Using a single name, we can store multiple values. Using a single name, using the same name only, we can store multiple values. Okay. So here array means collection of elements of same data type or group of elements of same data type. Okay, or group of homogeneous elements. So various definitions are there. Now let us take a simple example, right? So int a is equal to 5. Int a is equal to 5. Now if you want to store 5 values, so you can use arrays concept. How to use arrays? So there is a way. Okay, so here int is a data type and a is a array name and 5 is a size of this array, size of this array. Okay, now system will allocate 5 memory locations for this array, 5 memory locations, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? Now how to store these, how to store values into the array, how to store values into this array? Now different methods are there, so let me explain one of the method. So directly we can assign the values, for example, so 12, so 13, 16, 17, 19, let us check. Okay, now what is the size of the array? 5. That means we can store 5 elements. So here we have initialized 5 values, so 12, 13, 16, 17, 19. Okay. Now these values will be stored in sequential order. So 12, so 13, 16, 17, 19. 12, 13, 16, 17, 19. Now what is the name of this array? A. Okay. So remember that. So these values will be stored in sequential memory locations. Okay. Now first element is stored in 0th location. That means 0th index. Next one is 1. Next 2. Next 3. Next 4. Okay. Now in this way, the elements will be stored in sequential order. Sequential order. Okay. Now if you want to access these elements, now I'll tell you another way. Okay. Now system will allocate 5 memory locations now. So 0th location, 1st location, 2nd location, 3rd location and 4th location. What are the all these things? What is the size of this array? 5. So 5 memory locations allocated. Now what is the index of the first memory location? 0. Now what is the index of the last memory location? 4. Okay. Right. Now value 12 will be stored in 0th location. Next 13 will be stored in 1st location. 16 in 2nd location. 17 3rd location. 19 4th location. Okay. So in this way the values will be stored in sequential order. Right. Now let us assume that the address. The start, let us assume that the starting address of this memory location is 1000. Starting address of this memory location is 1000. What is the address of the next memory location? Okay, how to calculate it? Now, what variable A is, sorry, array A is declared as integer. Now, integer occupies 2 bytes. Integer occupies 2 bytes. Now, there is an integer which occupies 2 bytes. Which occupies 2 bytes. No? That means 1000 and 1001 is used for this memory location. So next memory location is 1002. Next one is 1004. Next one 1006. Next one is 1008. Now incremented by 2. Okay. Now what is an array? Array is a collection of elements of same data type. Array is a collection of elements of same data type. Now here 12, 13, 16, 17, 19 are integer data types. Integer data types. Now let us take one more example, float. Okay. So float height of 5. Height of 5. Now I want to store heights of the students. For example, 5.4, next 5.6, next 6.1, 6.1. Okay, now let us assume that the size of this array is 3. Size of this array is 3. Right. Now these three elements will be stored in sequential memory location. Okay. So 5.4 will be stored in 0th location, 5.6 is in first location, 6.1 is in second memory location. Now 5.4, 5.6, 6.1 are float data type. Float data type. All these values are of same data type only. All these values are of same data type. Which data type? Integer data. These are float data type. That's why array is nothing but collection of elements of same data type. For example, if you want to store 13.5, see here, 12 comma 13.5, 16, 17, 19. So 12, 16, 17, 19 are integer data type, but we are trying to store 13.5 in integer array. What will happen? What is the definition of array? Array is a collection of elements of same data type, but we are trying to store different types of elements. Is it valid? Of course, syntactically it is valid. But this 13.5 will not be stored in this memory location. Okay. So even though we mentioned 13.5, this 13.5 will not be stored in this memory location. Of course, 12 will be stored. Okay. 16. Okay. 17. Okay. 19 also will be stored. Whereas 13.5 will not be stored. Only 13 will be stored. Only 13 will be stored. Why? 13.5. So it is a floating point value. But A is declared as integer. A is declared as integer. So this array stores only integer values. Okay? Not other than the integer values. So that's why this 13.5 consisting of the two parts, one is integer part, second one is a fraction part. Only integer part will be stored in this memory location. Only integer part will be stored in this memory location. So that's why array is nothing but a collection of elements of same data. Now I'll take one more example also. So character, okay, ch of 5, ch of 5, or ch of, okay, 5-1. Now SMEC, okay, SMEC, how many characters are stored here? 4 characters, these are the characters only, okay, so SMEC, SMEC, 4 characters. Now it is an integer array, and this one is a float array, and the float data type array, and this one is character type of array. So integer array stores only integer elements. Float data type array stores only floating point values only. Character array can store only character constants. So that's why array definition is it is a collection of elements of same data type, or group of elements of same data type, or group of homogeneous elements. Okay. So that's about the introduction of the arrays. Now what I understand the difference between variable and array. A single variable contains only one value. Single variable contains only one value. Okay. So if you want to store two values, we have to use the two variables. If you want to store three values, we are using three variables. So instead of using the three variables, instead of using four variables to store multiple values, the best method is arrays concept only. Okay. So array, using arrays, we can store multiple values in using a single name, okay. So that's about the arrays. So I'll conclude that. What I understand here? So array is nothing but collection of elements of same data type. Integer array, integer data type array contains only integer type of element. Float data type array contains only floating point values. Okay. Character array contains characters, collection of characters. Okay, so that's about the arrays concept. Thank you. Thank you very much.